Well, Stars certainly turned it up in the style stakes for the first event of the Melbourne Cup Carnival on Saturday, showing off every shade of, well, black and white.
Oh, they were beautiful, yeah. And the rain couldn't even dampen spirits at Derby Day. 71,000 people.
Huge.
Got to the track here for the first time in 3 years.
And I think you spoke to most of them.
I did, yeah. Sarah showed me the ropes.
So this, my friend...
Yes.
..is the birdcage. The track is right there. The Paramount tent is somewhere over there. Do you want to go and have a look around?
Yes, I'm very excited.
Yeah? Got your drinking boots on?
You better believe it.
Gonna need them. Now stick with me, kid, and you'll be okay.
Yeah.
Hello. Thank you so much.
Hello.
Wait, hey, he's with me. They're trying to keep the riffraff out, that's why. A lot of champagne is poured in this tent. How much will you go through over the spring racing carnival?
So if we look at more glasses, I would say 2,700. 15,000 canapes to absorb that beautiful champagne. Yes, a lot of champagne is being served. I saw you
dancing in a crowded room. Derby Day with two of the network's biggest stars, Steve Quatermain and Sandra Sully. And Sulz, I love that you're a bit of a rebel today. You've bucked the black and white trend, as the Queen can do.
Well, I don't know about that, Sarah, but I love this Brisbane designer, Paul Hunt, and I thought this would be great for Derby Day. They set you guidelines. If you're from Melbourne, they're rules. To me, they're just guidelines.
No rules today. It's just great to be back at the track.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it seems like it's been 10 years. It's been, well, three, but it's forgotten how to get here, forgotten what to do. But we're here. It's a bit surreal.
Well, this is the form guide, apparently.
Yeah.
Who looks good?
Well, I reckon today, because everyone's trying to win because it's Derby Day, and it's the track's absolutely soggy. So I reckon tips go out the window today. Pick something you like, just pick a name you like or a number you like. Today, the $26 shot just won the first race, so I think it's going to be one of those days where being favourite means nothing.
Sheldon Riley, oh, you gorgeous, gorgeous man. First of all, tell us about your outfit.
Oh, stop it. A few feathers, huh?
Is that going to make it tricky to eat later?
We don't eat here, do we?
So, Hugh Sheridan, you are fresh off the back of a pretty big night in Melbourne.
I know. I did Solitary Man at Hamer Hall last night, and that was just after the Sydney Opera House. So, two of my favourite venues in the world. And
don't be humble. You got a 10-minute standing ovation.
I got a 10-minute standing ovation, and that's why I've been wearing my shades all day, because I was pretty excited.
I love Derby Day, it's my favourite day. I love the black and white, I love how people embrace the dressing theme. I said last year that after the 2 years it was very special to come together, and I think this year's been also really hard for a lot of people, and I think Melbourne's feeling pretty happy today.
Right, come on, you can't take me all the way to the race if we don't have a little bump.
Okay.
Oh, looking good.
Ooh, big story. I like that one. That's right. A nice name.
What a deal. You can't go wrong. What a deal.
Ooh.
What a deal it is.
Tijuana.
Big story tomorrow. Congo.
Look, I think we go by the name. Is 10 good odds?
Not better than 41. Look at 41 sounds good, doesn't it?
Let's put a few bucks on big story and see how we go.
Should you bring the money?
Where am I supposed to keep money in this outfit?
Brought the socks, I forgot to put the money in them.
Let's go. Let's go and ask Sam Pang, see if he's got any. Make me lose my mind.